It is sunny again. Yes! It feels like forever since we had sun. It's been a week or a week and a half, so, but it feels like forever when you don't see the sun. Especially after 6 long, cold winter months, then you just love these types of weathers. As you can see, the snow is slowly melting away. There's not much left. And I'm now standing over my rhubarb. Look, the rhubarb is coming up. I have to admit to you guys, the first time I saw this, I had no freaking idea what it was. I've never seen rhubarb in my life before. And when we bought the house, we had no idea that there was rhubarb. So like, this was coming up and then this massive plant emerged and was like, what is this? Can I eat it? And then slowly, by doing some research and asking people, it was like, oh, this is rhubarb. Yes! So I think I had about 10 kilos of rhubarb or more. So I'm now finally having breakfast and a cup of chaga tea. The chaga I harvest myself here in the forest, so that's a very great feeling to know where the chaga comes from. I am not only drinking chaga because it's really good for your immune system, because chaga really helps your body to adapt. So it doesn't matter if that's for stress or if you are battling a virus or bacteria. I feel that in this time when a lot of people are anxious and have fear, that chaga is really a helpful tea to drink or tincture to take to help your body cope and adapt with all the feelings that you're having, but it can also improve your immune system and in that way maybe protect you a little bit more from this virus that's been going on, but also from other viruses. But chaga is also really good in preventing chronic illnesses. A chronic illness is something that doesn't come falling out of the sky. It has built up to that point where you get cell damage, where you get a chronic, so a reoccurring pain or mental thought that just infests in your body. And our body gives a lot of signals and our body cries a lot for help. These are mostly the small symptoms that you're like, ah, I will take a paracetamol. Or if you go to the doctor, he's like, yeah, I don't know what to do, because your symptoms are not pointing towards one or more illnesses, so we don't know what to do. And chaga is really good as an adaptogenic, so it will help your body find back the natural balance and also battle all the things that are going on in your body, like inflammation, like viruses, like bacteria. But it can also help to prevent cancer, and in some cases can help to cure cancer. And now with this pandemic that's been going on, a lot of people are experiencing fear. A lot of people are experiencing the threat of this virus coming in our body. And the chaga can really help us not only to heal if we already have the virus, but also on forehand to make our body stronger. I always like being in a stream, especially in the spring. There's something about the moving water that just cleanses your body, your mind and your soul. By asking the water spirits to help you, you can really let go of all the burdens that you have been carrying around, and to start as clean as the spring water.
today I'm making a very simple but delicious recipe. You only need black beans, a vegetable stock cube, some ginseng powder, some reishi powder, celery, salad, and some bread, tortillas or tortilla chips, anything that you would like to eat this recipe with. Warm up the beans and add the vegetable stock cube. Once the beans are warm, you will mash them into a paste. Then it's ready to eat. One of the first herbs that shows its flowers is the tussilago. The name tussilago comes from the Latin word tussis, meaning cough, and ago, meaning to cast or to act on. Beautiful about this herb is that the flowers bloom before the leaves come, and you will rarely see them at the same time on the same place. You can recognize tussilago by a few significant marks. First is that you will only see the flowers and mostly not the leaves. The flower reminds us of the dandelion, but once you look at the stem, you can really see the difference. The stem of the tussilago is mostly reddish, but sometimes can also be white. And you can see almost dragon-like scales on the stem. Once you have found these marks, you can be sure that you have found your tussilago. This herb has been used to clear mucus in the lungs, work anti-inflammatory, and reduces cramps in the airways due to coughs. Overall, the herb can be used to strengthen the whole body after exhaustion and tiredness due to very high vitamin and mineral content. And it is a go-to herb after flu and congestion in the airways, tiredness and swollen glands. The color really speaks to our life force, and this herb shows that with energy, willpower, we can create and bloom by using our energy. The color also signifies the affection to the liver, which holds our energy. And in many shamanic traditions, it also works as a ground for the soul to connect to the body. A healthy, happy liver gives a healthy, happy, energetic, and powerful life. Lastly, the tussilago can stimulate the kidneys to drive out buildup fluids in the body. A word of caution, this herb contains alkaloids, which in high concentration can be harmful to the liver. So do not take this herb in excessive high amounts or for a very long period, plus 1 month in a row. This herb is safe to use as a cough syrup, herbal infused tea or a tincture. The tussilago flowers can be used in tea, but better as a cough syrup mixed with honey. This recipe I will share with you in the next video.
Juniperus berries are very strongly detoxifying.
Almost everyone is familiar with the aromatic incense burning sticks. But there's another way for you to use smoke and aromas to clean or uplift your energy, to clear your space of negative energies, or to connect deeper to the spirits. For this way, you use either fire or charcoal and a mixture of gums, herbs, and spices. My favorite blend is pine resin, rosemary, cinnamon, salt, bay leaf, and juniper to raise the vibration and clear out all the energies that need to be released. To calm my mind and open myself up again, I like to use pine resin, lavender, rosemary, and some elderberry flowers. I also have a favorite mix made by Creative Incense called Mystic Raven. This is not sponsored by them, but if you want to check out their nice products, I put a link in the description box down below. How to make your own incense is very easy. You need to first set an intention what the energy of the mixture would be. It can be a singular herb or a mixture of more. It is advised to use at least one sort of gum in the mixture, such as pine resin, myrrh, or frankincense, but you can also add multiple. Then you will mix the herbs together. Herbs that work powerful in clearing away harmful energies are rosemary, mugwort, bay leaf, juniper, and cinnamon. Herbs that work calming and opening are lavender, elderberry, hawthorn flowers, pine, both bark, resin, and needles, rosemary, and rose. Although you can add all non-toxic herbs to make these blends, not all will smell good while burning. It is believed that strong-smelling herbs carry out their spirit through the aroma and in this way penetrate the body's energetic field and change chemistry, thoughts, and feelings. There are many more herbs that you can use, and I will make these types of information available on my Patreon.